Hi, this is Dave from JavaCodeJunkie.com. In our previous video, we downloaded and installed the OpenJDK Java Development Kit. In this video, we're going to continue with the setup of our Java development environment, and we're going to download and install the Eclipse IDE. So let's open up your favorite browser and search for Eclipse Installer. Hit enter. Choose the first option, in this case, for 2019-12 release. That's the latest as of today. And we're going to be installing this on Windows, so I'm going to download and install the 64-bit Windows version. Click on the download button. Click OK so that Windows is happy with keeping the file. It'll just take a couple of seconds for that to download. Now, once it's completed, we can either click right here to install directly from the browser or go to wherever you have downloaded. In this case, I've downloaded to a folder called Downloads on my computer. I'll right click and I will run as administrator. And the Eclipse installer starts. And here you see all of the different packages that are available for Java from the Eclipse Foundation. The one that we want is this one right at the top, Eclipse IDE for Java Developers. So click on that one, and you'll see the next screen. The installer looks for a previously installed virtual machine. Now, the virtual machine on my system was installed with OpenJDK that we installed in the last video. And you'll see it's found that one in the installation folder. So in my case, I'm going to install it to development tools, Java development tools, we just fine. And you can browse and install wherever you'd like on your computer system. Once you're satisfied with the destination folder, just click on the install button at the bottom and the IDE will begin installing. It'll just take a moment again for that to complete. And once it's completed, we're going to give it a go. Just open it up and make sure that everything seems to work. And the installation completed successfully. So let's just launch the Eclipse Integrated Development Environment. And as is common with a lot of programs, the first run of the program may take a little longer than subsequent runs. Some initial setup that may be involved. So now we have to select a directory or folder as a workspace for the Eclipse IDE. Now the workspace is where all of our work files, our Java programs, and our Java code is going to be kept. You can browse to a folder on your computer, or you can simply accept the default, which I'm going to do. We'll click launch, and the program should start. There we go. And there's the program. Eclipse IDE has been successfully installed, and it's running. I'll just click on the help menu item, and about Eclipse IDE, you'll see we have version 2019-12. Thanks for watching. In our next video, we're going to continue with the setup of our development environment again. We're going to download and install a plugin for Eclipse that will allow us to more easily create JavaFX programs. Hope to see you then. Take care.